must have been a massacre! Bones everywhere! How in the world did Clevisig harness so much of the power?
Do you always get so excited at the sight of skulls, Deathmold?
Scoff all you want, I speak of magic! The kind of spells that win wars, thousands incinerated in seconds! Power, destruction, annihilation!
Yes, after which Sabrina Glevisig was burned at the stake, and the Pontar Valley remains within Edirne's borders.
Edirne is a carcass, still showing life signs, but the realm's days are numbered. No peasant revolt can change that.
You're wrong, Deathmold. This country lives. I can feel it. Like an old wounded bear covered in scars, hounds all round it, but still strong. Still deadly. This will be a good war.
But sire, the Edirnian barons won't dare stand against you. You shall see that shortly. I've prepared everything.
Okay. So I'm a king now. And I have someone called Deathmold. And I like war. Okay. Okay, so I am a king. And I have no inventory and cannot take weapons out. Do I have a journal? Yes, I do. Prelude to War, Caedwin. Is it Caedwin or Cadwin? Cardwin? Caedwin, probably more likely. At a time when Temeria and Aedirne were consumed by the chaos so typical of an interregnum, Henselt, Lord of Caedwin, was marching south to seize the dead Demivend's lands. While he had a dubious claim to Lormark, his actions were legitimized by the Law of Force. Aedirne was not completely defenseless, however. Saskia, the Dragon Slayer, the head of a peasant rebellion, blocked the path of Henselt's army. Stennis, Demivend's son, stood at her side. The King Caedwin was no fool, and though he felt certain of victory, he decided to hear what his opponents wanted to say. He had hoped to bribe or intimidate the Edirnian nobility, thus began a meeting which would later be fearfully described by chroniclers. So I'm heading off to a meeting, and by I mean Henselt, Lord of Caedwin. The Assassins of Kings, Geralt knew that Letho had teleported somewhere in the area of Vergen, and Triss Merigold arrived in the town's vicinity along with him. The Witcher began looking for the Kingslayer's trails. Okay. Death to the traitor, that's the last update I got. The Witcher did as he promised. He killed Loredo. Those who mourned the commander shed false tears, and those cheering outnumbered them greatly. I think that even though Geralt murdered a man, he made the world a better place. Oh, hell yeah. Perhaps not on a grand historical scale, but certainly on a scale of the hapless and downtrodden. Yeah, I'm actually kind of glad I got to kill him. Geralt found Morrel, an elven girl in the tower. The elf in the final stage of pregnancy needed to be brought outside as fast as possible. It turned out that it is easier to get inside Loredo's mansion than to get outside. The terrified Morrel started to deliver her child, but this time the Witcher was spared the difficult challenge. As skillfully as a certified midwife, Vess took charge of the delivery, proving claims that Roche's men are versatile. Geralt just had to buy the young mother some time, so he joined Vernon, who was holding back the attack in the courtyard. As always, the cavalry came late, though Roche later boasted that he'd saved the Witcher's skin. He did not! The battle in the courtyard of Loredo's mansion ended with a clear victory for the good guys. The enemy was beaten, disarmed, or routed. At a crossroads, Vernon Roche. But did he choose Roche? Yes, he did. Well, he didn't really choose Roche. He chose to continue on the trail of trying to find the Kingslayer without joining the bloody Skoytal. I actually kind of like Yorveth, but I don't want to be on anyone's side, at least with Vernon. I'm not really on anyone's side other than trying to find the Kingslayer. That's what Roche wants. I mean, he also wants to kill the Skoytal, but I'm not helping him do that. I'm helping him track down the Kingslayer. Yes, he did. Geralt agreed to help Roche in relieving Flotsam of its troubles. The problem had a name, Laredo. After dealing with the commander, both wanted to start searching for Triss. Mystic River. Geralt found a letter to one Deathmold in the mailbox in Bernard Laredo's mansion. It suggested that the commander had not been all that upset by Foltest's death, and seemed more interested in King Henselt's health. Apparently Laredo was colluding with the Caedwenis and had far-reaching plans. The commander also apologised for his mother's behaviour, which confirmed the rumours that she was erratic. All right. Interesting. So, they were in contact with Deathmold, who is the guy next to me on my left. Did he choose Yorveth? No, he didn't. Our hero decided to cooperate with Roche. Rest assured, however, that the Witcher will cross paths with the warlike Scoia'tael again. Of course I will. Alright, so I've got a meeting to get to. It's odd that I end up playing other people, but fine. Follow me. So that's Deathmold. Can I talk to anyone? No. And Sheila is with me. And I can't run. I suppose that would be undignified.
Greetings, Your Grace.
Hail to Henselt.
Yeah. Open the doors. Oh, no. My bad. Never mind. Oi! Excuse me. Out of my way. I'm the king. Thank you. Really, can't I run? No one's looking. No one can see. We could just jog a little bit. No?
The towns of Hill, can you feel that? Magic still beats strongly in this place. Shivers run down my spine.
Strange. Glevasig's quadruple sun is a short duration spell. It should have dissipated long ago.
An anomaly, perhaps. Not uncommon. The sheer amount of power she summoned. I doubt she retained complete control.
Stop discussing Sabrina Glevasig.
Sabrina.
I promise you that heads will roll.
Okay.
Sire!
Long live the king!
Yeah. Long live me. Although, not if I don't get some exercise. I mean, really? So somebody summoned a spell that added four suns, probably like meteors or something.
Baron Fellet has forever hinted that he would gladly change his
plan. Kedwin! All wheels and forever! Scum.
The other nobles are panic-stricken at the very thought of Saskia with her peasant and non-human rebels. They are unprepared to fight and know it very well.
And Demoven's cob? Has he named his price?
Prince Stennis has yet to respond, but Felot has assured me.
I must see him. Look into his eyes. I'll know what he's made of then.
Okay. So I'm that kind of person, am I?
We most humbly greet His Majesty Henselt, King of Kedwin, heir to the dynasty of the Unicorn, Lord of Ard Carraig, Archduke of Banard, and Vanquisher of Nilfgaard.
Welcome to Edirne.
Edirne.
How much do you want?
Edirne.
Your Majesty surely jests.
I couldn't be more serious. How much for your signatures?
100,000 Novigrad crowns, we thought. To each of us. And the titles of Marquis.
Ooh.
We speak of Upper Edirne.
Edirne.
Of coal and silver mines, numerous factories. The sole white marble quarry this side of the Yoruga and the North's main east-west trade route.
We speak of Lawmark. I advise you to adopt the new nomenclature.
Nomenclature.
In exchange, we shall swear fealty and acknowledge your majesty as sovereign of these lands.
I'll give you half. Why do... See, I don't really want to care. I'll give you half.
You'll receive 50,000 apiece and no additional titles. Also, You'll provide guides and supplies to my army. My men will install themselves in your castles. Your armed men will gather under Sorcerer Deathmold's command and will set out to quell the peasant rebellion.
Sire, the common folk will hate. They simply won't understand.
Yes, Ferret, they will hate you, but at least this way you'll live. Comfortably, I might add. Refuse and die by my hand or that of Saskia the Dragon Slayer.
Am I wearing a belt made of castles, sort of thing?
Sire, we accept your conditions.
Deathmold, the scroll.
Sire, there is yet the matter of Prince Stennis and his rights to these lands. So long as he lives, so long as the prince lives, he'll force his claims.
Oh, speak it out, mate. Yeah, just say it.
Sire, I'm no warrior.
In that case, shut up and sign.
I really don't like...
Sire, the Dragon Slayer approaches, white flag in hand.
Excellent. Let her pass.
What are you waiting for? Pick up those quills and sign.
Just out of curiosity, what does Upper Eden sell for these days?
50,000. How much would you have demanded, lass?
King, command your vulture to shut his beak before I thrust his cockerel up his arse and twist so hard he'll crow until noon reverts to morning.
Oh, I like her.
Sire, you must have her restrained.
Silence! Yeah, no, silence. We like her. Shut up. I'm king.
Shut up, Deathmold. I've rather taken a liking to this Saskir. Say your peace, woman.
King, withdraw your army, recognize Upper Eden's sovereignty and your persecution of non-humans, and give them leave to quit your realm. Do this and save yourself and your army.
You have balls, woman, but what would I gain? My soldiers would call me a coward. I am Henselt of Ard Carraig. I'll not run from a woman, even if she be a dragon slayer.
I'm beginning to wish I'd...
I see one other solution.
Gone with Yorvith.
You and I, King, here and now, before these folk and the gods, I challenge you.
She's awesome.
As in the old days, when the honorable ruled this world, Upper Eden, to the victor.
The lass has gone mad to challenge a king.
Sire, this is absurd. We shall crush them in battle. They say the lass has slain a dragon. She could be dangerous.
I'll fight. Yes, I will.
Precisely why she makes a worthy foe. Don't disappoint me, Dragon Slayer. Please show me how it's done. Begin.
Oh, am I going to be... Is this going to be one of those fights where I've got absolutely no options? Just start. Just hit.
Facing one another in a chivalrous duel shall be Henselt of Ard Carraig, King of Kedwin, Sovereign of Caengorn and Malior, last of the line of the Unicorn.
I want her to win, though.
And Saskia, the wench who killed a dragon. The victor shall take Lormar.
Like,
may the gods settle this. Begin!
Draw your sword!
I did. Okay. She's... I don't really... Okay, it's gotta be the blocks. It's gotta be the parry. Okay. Okay, I was gonna say, I don't want to kill her, even though I wanted to win the fight.
Stop in the name of Creve, Freyr, and Militale.
What? Oh god. Okay. And I really don't like me. I just killed a priest on a magic runestone. Yeah. That seems like a bad idea now. Oh, good. All right. Who the hell are these people?
Hey, halt!
What's with you, Zivik? Booze Major Batty. Don't you recognize me?
I'll be ploughed and damned. Why the hell did you bring him here, Roach?
He's a witcher.
I know who the Horson is. Ploughing Kingslayer at the gate of a king's camp? Why, he's not even bound.
Easy, lads. The witcher's no murderer, I'll vouch for that. As for kings, well, I desperately need to see yours.
You're in for a wait then, Mr. Special Mission Knight.
Magic? Danger? Both?
Don't move, mutant! One of you go get the sergeant, and while you're at it, fetch a solid piece of rope to bind the freak.
Come on, Zivik, no need for that. Where'd you say the king was?
Out in the field somewhere, negotiating. Hey, Kingslayer, drop your weapons, or do I need to pack a bolt up your arse? Don't move! Don't even twitch, mutant!
Something is coming.
Hands where I can see him! Shoot! Smash the freak!
Okay.
What the fuck?
Okay, is this gonna be the dragon? Okay. We're letting her live then, right? Oh, you're in trouble. Oh, no you're not. I'm here. I mean Geralt this time.
These spectres were my soldiers.
Okay.
Sabrina's corpse. Edernians are here as well.
My eyesight's late. We have to go on our own.
Okay. Kidwenny Knight's Wraith. I'm actually dying. Oh god, really, just totally dying. Horribly, badly. Brilliant. Great start. Okay, these guys are tough. Yeah, of course. Just want to load in the last save. Of course I bloody well do. As long as the last save's now. Alright, okay.
It's Sabrina's curse.
Okay. I'm just trying to dodge, I'm behind. Okay. Oh, we got them all over the bloody place. Okay, I'm bleeding. Shield up. Okay, I'm really not happy. No potions. How many have we got to kill? Really, how many have we got to kill? Oh, more of them. Oh, I'm bleeding. Oh, I'm in lots of trouble. I've got no swallow. Okay. What the... Okay. Roll. Oh, okay. Let's see if they fall for the trap. Will they fall for the trap? Fall for the trap. Those was anyone will heal me, would they? Come on. Come over here. Trap time. Nice. Roll time. Go on, through my trap. Let them through my trap, guys. Okay, or don't. And what were these? Draw gear. Okay, they don't respond particularly. Oh, I'm bleeding. No! Oh my god. Really? I gotta go back to the start of that one as well. Oh my god. Oh god, this is really annoying.
My other sights later. We have to go in.
Come on, any of you? Try not to take damage. We're going to need all the health we can get for later on. Okay. Okay. Let's save vigor for strikes. Yeah, save vigor for damage on strikes. Okay. Okay, right, so we got full health this time. I don't think that does anything, so. Oh, Essence of Death. Roll. Okay. Come on. Charge. No. You're going to keep fighting Roche, are you? I'm trying to get him to charge into me. He's not going to, though. Come into my trap, no? Okay, are we actually making a dent on him at all? How about Igni? I don't think it did anything. Oh, actually, that might have actually done some damage. Oh, that is damaging him. Oh, that just missed. Another Igni. Yep, Igni. Igni's the way to go. Okay. And get out of there. Oh, God, no, I'm bleeding. Little better. Hooey. And you couldn't do that 5 minutes ago.
Ready. Stay close to
more?
What the hell? Where did the sun go? It's an eclipse. Somebody cast a curse.
I kind of want to. Oh, we got to stay within this. We got to. Silver and spells. I can't loot them because I'm in combat. I don't. So they take damage within this. Okay, that's good. I don't really need to actually fight them, do I? I can just let him do it all. Okay, no, they're coming.
Prince Dennis. He lives.
Okay, taking. Okay. Okay, another one done.
Die. It's Clevisic's curse. She's out to kill me.
Who's that to kill?
It's not far now. Let's hope so.
Okay, this mage is... Oh, I'm taking... I unfortunately, I'm not got the ability to regenerate, so... I'm just going to put the shield on, to be honest, at the moment. It almost seems like damage is not something I need to do. Just stay close and stay alive. Okay. Oh, behind. He's doing a pretty good job of killing them, though. Oh, God. Wraiths. Where's the other one? Oh, where that?
The fog is dissipating. We're near its end.
Okay, so it's the fog. Get out of the fog and we're fine. To be honest, I'm not totally sure why I'm even attacking. Have any of them got close yet?
Take that,
he says. Stood there, watching the guy do everything for us. No, I don't think I'm actually needed. I think I'm panicking over nothing. Now I'm needed. Raids, kill the raids. Oh, God. Oh. Okay, what the hell? Stay in there. What the hell is... I can't attack the floating raids anymore. Okay. Keep the shield up. Oh God. Okay. Really feel like I've chosen the wrong side here. Not that I want to help the Scoia'tael, but that Saskia person seemed really cool. This king person, kind of tough, but a bit of an ass.
Deathmold, Sheeler.
And he has someone called Deathmold.
You're to explain what the hell happened there, and how we're to get rid of it.
As you command, Your Majesty.
I'll tolerate no delays on this matter, and summon all my company commanders.
Immediately. Your Majesty.
Corporal, I'd like you to watch the Witcher closely. He just pulled me from a magic hell, so I doubt he wants my head as he took fall tests. But I'll not have him wandering round the camp like some stray dog. Occupy him for a time, then bring him to my tent.
Sire, I must request an audience.
Later. I'll see my mages first, then the Witcher.
Okay.
Ah, just lovely. And here I'd hope for a calm little war.
Know where I might wet my throat around here?
Roach, willing to vouch for this overgrown urchin?
He did not kill Foltest or Demavend, if that's what you're asking. You've got my assurance on that.
Good enough for me. Let's go then.
Okay. Follow Zivik, or convince you to lead him to the king. No. We'll follow. Bring it on. Arm wrestling. Oh, I can do some arm wrestling. Because that's the first thing on my mind, isn't it, really? You're going to slam the door in my face. Hating you already. Yes, I am. So, we've got a camp.
We don't have all day.
Shut up.
Our armorer. Busy as ever with military commissions, but he'll take a private commission from time to time.
Okay, armorer. Got it. So you're going to give me the tour now, are you? I don't suppose we can run, can we? Didn't think so. Yeah. Back in another war encampment.
We're here at last. The canteen, the most important place in the camp. If you ever get bored, you should find a monster contract or two on the notice board.
Really? I can actually do Witcher business around here. As well as... Irwin.
Let's go.
Who are you? Diamond dust, twice.
We don't have all day.
Whatever. Okay.
Let's go.
Oh, fine, tavern. Yes, sorry, you're giving me a tour of the place.
We don't have all day.
Shut up. Armorer, tavern. I thought you were leaving me at the tavern so I could, you know. Hello. Do we know each other? Look familiar.
Going against the saint. The enemy have fed you their propaganda. Ah, what if she's really an anointed there? Don't worry.
Someone's an anointed. Yeah.
Here's where the king organizes tournaments. All glamour, ceremony, noses and cocks in the air. Between those, we kill time thrashing about with swords, pikes, chairs, the works. Good stuff. No holds barred. They pay well, too, if you know who to talk to and who to bet on. Excuse me a moment, Witcher.
Okay.
How did the fight go?
You're the nose for this, Zivik. You won again.
My gold?
You gonna bet on more fights today?
Of course. I'll come by later.
So am I gonna get a chance to fight in there? Or bet on fights. And we've got an elven prisoner.
See him, Witcher?
Yeah.
Loosen his bonds a bit and he's liable to jump at your throat like a rabid mutt.
One of your Biscoyatel. How did you capture him?
Scouts found him wounded in the ravines. Someone massacred a small unit. The boy said it was a bloodbath, as if the Reaper just swung his scythe right through them. Whoever attacked them was very strong.
Any idea who it might have been?
No. But if they managed to ambush elves in the wild, I'd rather not meet them.
Right, Zivik. Let's go see the king.
Really? Can we not hang around here first? No? Gotta go see the king. Alright, I suppose that's fair enough. So, we got a tavern, an elf, an armourer.
How's it going, lads?
What, looks like an arena?
I can't feel me ploughing feet from all this standing around. Any chance you'll be sending up some replacements?
In an hour. Open up the gate. The king wants to see the Witcher.
Yeah.
Go straight to the royal tent. You can't miss it. I've a few things to take care of.
Godspeed, Zivik.
I'll be near the main gate if you need me. So long.
Ha!
Okay.
The Witcher.
Yes.
The king must have summoned him to fight the wraiths.
Fight the wraiths. Yeah, that could be. What? What is this?
Did they hire a
mages?
Witcher?
Hey. Lots of provisions. Provisions for the war. For fighting. All right. Is this the tent? It looks like the tent.
Nearly everyone hunts you, yet you live in spite of that. Impressive.
Win it.
In no small part.
Yeah, that's
to you, Excellency.
I've helped you. Yes. I trust I shan't regret it.
As do I. I wouldn't want to seem ungrateful.
Are you seeking employment? I was unaware you fellows hired yourselves out for battle.
My aim here is different.
Really? Perhaps I can be of assistance.
What are you doing here, Your Excellency? Shame about Foltest. Where to next? Alright, no, let's just... No, let's go straight to the point. What are you doing here?
What's the Emperor's envoy doing here? Satisfy my curiosity.
The last unfortunate conflict left the Northern Kingdoms in pitiful economic condition. His Imperial Majesty desires stability. We wish to offer financial assistance, so I'm visiting those lands hardest hit by the war.
Henselt is coping admirably as far as I can see.
The details of my visit here are reserved for the Emperor and the Kedweni King.
Okay, sure you can't tell me something, Excellency? Or should I try? I have a feeling trying the Jedi mind trick on him is a bad idea, but let's try.
You sure they're that big a secret? I mean, they could be important to me.
Oh!
I can
successful.
Reveal one thing. The Emperor was very moved to hear the White Wolf had returned. He
okay.
asked me to investigate the matter personally and submit a report.
Why do I interest him?
He didn't say. His Imperial Majesty keeps his motivations to himself.
Shame about Foltest.
Foltest was a good king. Shame he ended that way.
I've already conveyed the Emperor's condolences to Constable Natalis. Since we're talking about Temeria and Foltest, apparently the fallen king's advisor, the sorceress Triss Merigold, has disappeared in mysterious circumstances. Rumors abound. Do you know anything about her?
Tell
him
you ask, Excellency.
Yeah.
I heard the two of you are close.
Mages sometimes. Let's be enigmatic.
Mages have a natural tendency to disappear into thin air once in a while. Why is anyone concerned?
Maybe they wonder if witches locked in dungeons possess the same capacity. You're avoiding the subject, which means it's uncomfortable for you. Have it your way. I shan't press. But I'll ask one more question, if I may.
Of course, Your Excellency.
I mentioned Triss because, I must admit, I am perturbed. Mages are known for their mutual envy and rivalry. I wonder if there's any matter that could unite them.
Perhaps you could be a bit clearer, Excellency.
Then I shall ask directly. Do you know anything about Merigold's involvement with an organization of sorceresses?
Oh.
Assuming, of course, that you are...
talking about Philippa.
...or have been close.
You're talking about Philippa. Why does this interest you? Yeah, okay, come on.
I'm not sure why the acquaintances of a sorceress would interest a Nilfgaardian ambassador.
Many things interest me. Art, for example. A very interesting statuette was delivered to me today. A peculiar piece, elusive, sensuous. It forces one to think. Even a monster slayer might not be indifferent to the beauty entrapped within.
Maybe, but I'm afraid I don't have time to admire art.
Do you have any other queries? I have some matters to which I must attend.
Why are you so interested in this organization of sorceresses?
I wonder about some strange coincidences. I'm told several of them were seen in the vicinity when the assassination attempts occurred.
What's so suspicious about that? Mages have always thronged around monarchs, a source of power and coin.
I'm not accusing anyone. I merely said it makes me wonder.
To be honest, that's not too far-fetched, is it? A bunch of ex-witches working with sorceresses? Okay, so where do we go from here?
I saw you with Foltest before. Now you're with Henselt. No doubt you'll visit the King of Redania next.
I need not go far. Radovid is en route to Loch Muin. Perhaps he has already arrived.
Radovid.
We'll meet there.
He married...
Loch Muin? Ancient Elven city, quite a ways away, near the source of the Pontar. Why there?
The mages wish to re-establish their council. They sent out invitations to all the kings.
Okay. Yeah, I've really stepped right in the middle of the Viper's Nest here, haven't I?